Hey guys, my name is Pedrowski, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can set up a satisfactory dedicated server. Now to do this we're going to be using a tool called Pterodactyl, and so that's something you need installed on your server. If you don't have it already, just go check out my other video. I'll leave a link in the description in the top right hand corner. It's super simple to set up, it takes you less than 10 minutes, and basically it gives you a nice panel where you can manage and edit all your game servers from just a easy to use interface. The reason why we're going to set up Satisfactory this way is because it just works compared to other methods. There's a lot of messing around and tweaking options, and it just works. So this is the exact same way that we run our 40 slot server for the /r Satisfactory. So to get started, so we just need to be logged into our Pterodactyl panel, and then we go over to the settings on the right hand side. Now we need to go down to nests. So nest, and then we need to create a nest. Basically what this is, Pterodactyl uses these things called eggs. And eggs basically hold the server configuration, and a nest will hold different server configurations. So we're gonna just create a new nest. We're gonna call it custom. We click save, and then we click on nest again. And now we can just click import egg, and then we're going to choose file, going to select the satisfactory egg. Now I'll leave a link in the description for that as well, so it's super easy, just literally download it and do exactly what I'm showing you here. Then we change the associated nest to custom, so we click import, literally takes a second. Now we can install satisfactory servers on the computer. So now we go over to servers, create new, and let's just call it Satisfactory. Type in the server owner, which you would have already set this up if you followed my previous guide. We can set the memory and disk space to 0. The reason why we set it to 0, we're just allowing it unlimited resources on the computer. You can limit this if you want, if you know what you're doing, but generally just setting it to unlimited is going to be fine, especially if it's just you and a few friends. And now we go down to nest configuration. So then we select custom, and it should have automatically selected satisfactory. Now, if we come down to the service variables, we can also change how many players we want the server to be. So say we want a 10 player server, we just set that to 10, and then we click on create server. So as we can see, that's installing now. Now we just need to do a few other things, because Satisfactory doesn't allow you to use other ports right now. So we have to allocate the ports to the server. So if we go to nodes, we click on our server, we click allocation, and then let's grab the server IP address. Make sure it's just got the IP address in there, not HTTP. Now we can add the ports. So we want to add the ports 15,000, and the other one is 15,777. So we add both of those ports, click submit. Now we can see the ports have been added to the server. Now we have to add them to the instance, but the instance needs to finish installing first. So let's just double check that. Let's see, we can see here it's still installing. So we literally just need to wait for this to finish. It's pretty much almost finished. So let's just wait for that and then I'll come back to it. Okay, so now we're back. We can see the Pterodactyl says our server is running. We can also see here in the console, it says server marked as running. We don't really need to worry about any of these other errors. So what we can do now, we can just stop the instance. Then we can go over to this little button here, which will load up the server settings. Okay, now we click on build configuration. And we just got to assign the ports. So we're going to assign the port 15,000 and 15,777. Then we click update and then start. So this is a good time. You can just copy your IP address from here. You don't need the port. And then, yep, server's running. So then we can go over to Satisfactory. Click on Server Manager. My internet's pretty crappy, so it's probably gonna take a few times to do this, but if we just paste the IP address under address, we can just leave the port as we've already set it up. Click Connect. Okay, yeah, here we go. This shouldn't happen if you have decent internet. I just have crappy internet. So here we go. The server's unclaimed, so let's just call it Satis server, for example. Confirm. It's going to ask for an administration password. So you can just type this in. This is just for you if you want to change some settings on the server or run console commands. So click confirm. And then we just need to create the game or the world. So let's just go grass fields. Let's call it LOL. Call it whatever you want. It doesn't really matter. And then auto join and create game. And let's just see if it lets us in the game. So if you guys are watching this, you get stuck at any point, I'll leave a link to my Discord below. So you can come join, ask questions if you get stuck, or even just leave a comment and I'll do my best to respond. But as you can see here, using Pterodactyl, it's very straightforward. If you're using something like Steam, CMD, or AMP, there's just a lot more little configuration things that you need to do. So yeah, here we go, starting up, working as intended, and we're in. So we're in the server. And that's it. You've got your own dedicated server running. So what we can do, we can come back to Pterodactyl as well. We can do other things. So we can set up a backup, for example. You actually need to set the backups in the build configuration. So yeah, we can change the backup limit if we want to have some backups on the server. So if someone griefs the server or does something wrong, you know, we've adjusted that. We can create a backup. Just lull one. Backups are starting. Can set a schedule. So what I've found is that Pterodactyl will actually use quite a bit of CPU. Satisfactory. We use quite a bit of CPU once the server's been up for a little while. So it's best to just set like an auto restart. I found that every 12 hours is a good amount of time for a restart. So right now, if we left our main server on, which has like probably 4 or 5 players at any one time, the CPU usage will basically half as the second we restart it. So that's another good thing. And if you also need to give other people access, so you can stop and restart the server, you can literally just come over to users and create an account and they can log straight in and do whatever they need to do. So that's the benefits of using Pterodactyl. So that's it, guys. If you enjoyed the video or it helped you, just leave a comment and subscribe. You know the usual, leave a like. And again, if you get stuck, leave a comment and come join our Discord. We're more than willing to help. Thanks for watching, guys.